In the past, shipping a product or launching a company was only an option for those who had the money, or for those who could attract an investment from venture capitalists. Crowdfunding websites like Kickstarter and Indiegogo have drawn a lot of attention from entrepreneurs, policymakers, investors, and the public. Their enthusiasm is understandable. Today, these internet marketplaces connect people seeking funds with hundreds, if not thousands, of supporters. But the idea that an entrepreneur could raise funds from a large number of sources, each providing just a small amount, isn't really new. In 1985, Paul Hogan and John Cornell tapped 1,400 Australian investors to produce the blockbuster movie Crocodile Dundee. In the 1970s and 80s, limited partnerships, which required minimum investments of no more than $2,000, became a popular form of financing everything from shopping malls to oil and gas exploration. And charities, of course, have long relied on funding drives that aggregate thousands of small donations. What is new is the emergence of powerful internet platforms that enable funding campaigns. These crowdfunding platforms lower the costs of running a campaign by leveraging the geographic and social reach of the internet to connect fundraisers with millions of potential backers. In exchange, these platforms charge a fee, typically a percentage of the amount raised. There are four major crowdfunding models. It's easiest to classify them according to what they offer in exchange for the funds they receive, either equity, debt, some type of a reward, or nothing but the satisfaction of donating to a good cause. Equity-based sites such as AngelList and CircleUp provide a platform where people can sell shares of their company. This type of funding only represents a small fraction of all crowdfunding activity. Legal and practical constraints have slowed things down, but upcoming regulatory changes could make a big difference. Today, peer-to-peer lending sites like LendingClub offer a crowdsourced solution for debt. It's part of a larger revolution in financial tech, internet software that aims to disrupt the traditional finance industry. While banks typically serve as an intermediary for loans, the peer-to-peer model allows one person, or many, to lend money directly to those who need it. This allows savers to earn more and borrowers to pay less. Rewards-based sites are one of the major innovations in crowdfunding. Funders back campaigns that interest them with the promise of receiving something in return, usually a copy of whatever project they're backing. Kickstarter is the most well-known example of this model, and has been used to fund everything from the creation of albums and short films to the development of 3D printers and smartwatches. Finally, there are charity platforms like Causes or CrowdRise. Fundraisers usually do not offer anything in return for donations except for the information and feedback about the good deeds that those campaigns have enabled. Crowdfunding has been growing at a steady rate worldwide, opening up new opportunities for both entrepreneurs and investors. Crowdfunding has already demonstrated the ability to promote innovation, wealth creation, and more. But of course, it has also revealed certain potential shortcomings. To find out more, please read the California Management Review special issue on crowdfunding and subscribe to our channel for the latest business insights from top global researchers.